Okay, so good day everyone. Today I will discuss you about the payroll system and the timekeeping system. So this is the interface of our payroll system, and this is the timekeeping, which is included already the the computerized biometric. Okay, so this is the computerized biometric natin. So you can use the fingerprints and the scanner. Okay. So after that, we also included the meal monitoring. So we installed in the cafeteria. So every time na the employee will avail the meal, staff meal, they will log in to monitor how many times that employee is availed his meals for that day. Okay, so we close it now. So we proceed first on the payroll master, kumbaga. So this is the interface of our payroll system. So as you can see, this is the quick look wherein you can see the summary of the data inside this system. Okay, so first you need to log in. So this is the username password. So click log in, and this is the tabs for payroll master file, wherein you can add the employee data. Okay, so to add the employee data, you need to click employee profiles, this one, and here's the sample of employee we encoded. To add a new employee, new add button here, and you can see the wherein you can add the personal data of employee, employment, payroll, wages, and government benefits natin. Okay, so I click the one of the employee here, and here's the data we encoded. So the last name, the first name, and other information of the employee. And here's the other tab for employment, wherein you can add the date hired of employee, date of contract expiration, and this is the regularization and any information. So here on the company, we can set what specific company or the agency is the employee assigned. So let's say, for example, you have a four or five agency for your hotel, so you can set it here. Okay, so the other one is the position. So you can select what position is that employee. Okay, assignment, employment status, so it's regular or agency or provisionary. So depends on the employment status of the employee. So department, so you can add also the department. So it's housekeeping, F&B. Okay, so you can set it here. And also the section, so you can add also a section if you want to. Okay, and here also we have here a box for resigned employee, so you can set what's the cost of living with the company. So pwede mo ilagay dyan. So payroll wages naman, so we're here, we have a sample of payroll groupings, payroll group. So as of now, I set semi payroll, so that's for 1 to 15 and 16 to 30 semi payroll. So I set here a sample of category natin, so semi monthly. Okay, per day basis natin. So I put the how many working days in a month and working hours in a day. Okay, so here also in the taxes, so I set also the taxes. This is as field health pag ibig. Okay, and this is the labor rates natin. So wherein this is ito yung mga multiplier. Okay, multiplier based dun sa time in and time out natin. So okay, and here ito yung WD is, it stands for work day, and OTH is stands to OT hour, and night differential ends for night differential hours siya. Okay, so and this stands for OD, ordinary day. So ito naman yung rest day, special holidays, special holiday and rest day niya. Okay, so may regular holiday naman siya, and ito yung regular holiday and rest day niya. So ito yung mga what's this, kumbaga multiplier. Okay, So kung pumasok siya ng rest day niya, pero pumasok siya, that's automatic 1.3. Kung special holiday man, pumasok siya, that's another 1.3. Okay, if ever na rest day niya, special holiday and rest day, so that 1.5 and that so on. Okay, it's the same with the overtime. Okay, and the other side naman, meron tayong attendance remarks naman natin, which is you can input the what's the multiplier for OB and the official time off, and this is the leave with pay and leave without pay. So this is the deduction since it is -1. Okay, so the other side naman tab natin is the peso per minute. This is the tardiness deductions natin. So every company naman, kanya-kanya namang policy. So either peso per minute, minute late times 2 times minute rate. So itong number 2. So depende naman yan sa company kung ano yung ginagamit natin na formula for the tardiness deduction. So as of now, we'll select for demo purposes yung peso per minute natin. Okay. So after that, here on the, you can see the for monthly. Okay, so monthly rate natin. So also now we have here the 30,000 monthly rate of employee. So mamili ka lang. So either you're using monthly or a daily rate. So you can click after that. Put the rate of employee. So let's say 40,000 on monthly, and you want to get the daily rate of employees, just click this one button. So that's divide monthly rate divide 26 days, because depends on the so meaning one day off for every week. So that's 26 days in a month working day. Okay, so just click mo lang yan, and automatic the system will compute the daily rate. Okay. So then the longevity, or for the allowance here, and also daily allowance. Okay, so longevity, if there's a employment longevity, depende kasi yan sa company. Sometimes they are adding longevity rate, kung say gaano katagal, so pwede ka mag additional dun sa natin, additional earnings natin for the employee. And the total rate natin, ito magiging total rate niya. Okay, so dito yung hourly rate natin, so you can compute that one, so ito yung, this is stands for overtime naman natin, kung in case ng overtime tayo kung ilang oras, this is dito magbe-base kung kano yung hourly rate natin. And for the bank account naman natin, so you put it here, the bank account of your employee, and the bank kung saan natin dire-deposit yung payroll ni employee. Okay, so ano ba yung ano niya, is SA or CA. So okay, so after that, on the other side naman is the government benefits. Free-in, you can input the number of employee, SSS, field health, pag-ibig, and field number. Okay, this is the withholding tax naman natin. Free-in, dito natin in-input kung magkano yung taxes, income tax na i-deduct natin dun sa per employee. Okay, so lagyan mo dito yung tax status niya. Okay, so ito naman yung SSS field health contribution natin. And ito naman yung ER, or yung employer share. Okay, so click mo yan, automatic naman si system mo kukompute kung ano yung bracket, kung saan bracket magpo-full yung contribution ni employee. Okay, so after that, update mo lang since we have a changes on the rate of employee or the data of employee. Update lang. Okay, since we have already encoded the information of employee, we can add also here the family background of employee. So here you can add new, and you can input the name information of family background, and also for the educational background, contract and appraisal, wherein you can add also here. So let's say you have an appraisal for this specific employee, and on that period you can set the period until to what period, and what is the evaluation rate natin. And also you can summarize the remarks of this employee. No, so you don't need to open the 201 files, or buksan mo yung 201 files para tingnan mo pa yung yung what's this, yung info, yung data, yung 201 file niya, kung ano yung mga na-appraise sa kanya, anong rate pa to. So you don't need to do that if meron ka ng record dito sa system natin. Okay. So meron din dito sa employment history natin. So of course, pwede mo ilagay dito mga employment history niya, trainings niya, okay, violations niya. So pwede mo din ilagay dito ang mga leaves file niya. So dito lahat pwede mo maipasok. Okay? So you can change also the profile pic, no, and open folder. So you can select also the, so let's say may mga scan documents ka, no, scan documents, pwede mo dito ilagay yung ano, yung lahat ng mga kumbaga scan documents na intended for this employee para dito nakatago. So pwede, you can open that one, no, and gawa ka ng folder dyan, then lagay mo lahat ng mga record dyan na intended for that employee. Okay, so after that, so since we already encoded the ano, encoded the employee data, so we proceed to the is timekeeping. So re-in dito na tayo, gagawa ng timekeeping ni, or yung mga login logout ni employee, kumbaga pati yung schedule nila. Okay, so same pa rin, mag-login tayo, click login and click natin yung employee profile. So after that, you click refresh. So para lahat ng mga changes doon na nangyari doon sa payroll master natin, we will take effect in here sa timekeeping system natin, since this is different system naman to. Okay. So after that, so since na-add na natin siya, no, dito na lahat-lahat ng mga employee natin, we'll go to fingerprint registration. So ito yung fingerprint registration, just click this logo, okay? And click natin yung access natin na i-register natin yung fingerprint ng employee. So let's say for example ito, click natin si Juan de la Cruz, and ito what fingers, what finger yung i-register niya. So dito we have an option of 5 fingers na i-register natin. So let's say kung hindi ito gagana, ito pwede siya, and we have 5 fingers na pwede i-register. Okay, so after that, close lang natin to. Okay, so since after registration, so kailangan natin magkaroon sila ng schedule. Okay, so lagyan natin ng schedule per employee. So so now since we have here, we have 4 employee. So let's say for example, so you can filter it by company. Okay, so you can filter it by department. Let's say for example, it's all admin. If the employee is all admin, so you can select it. And let's say, so same lang sila ng schedule. So pwede mo siya, let's say ito, magkaiba yung schedule niya. So siya lang i-check mo. Tapos siya yung gagawan mo ng schedule for that specific employees na chinek mo. So if ever naman na lahat sila, pare-parehas lang na yung schedule niya, so you can check it all. Okay, check it all para ma-check ito lahat. And e-edit mo na yung schedule nila. So before that, you can set it here, the start date. So let's say you're editing May 1 until 15. Okay. And after that, so here, so as of now, may na-encode na tayo na schedule kanina. So that's why makita natin dito. Pero if ever nag-change yung schedule natin, kaya pa rin gagawin natin. So check all and click add or update by batch schedule. Okay. So check natin yan, and yes natin, so lahat po yun. And let's say for example, nag-change yung schedule natin into 9, into let's say 9 a.m. pasok niya, lawat natin 6. And kung may break hours tayo, lagay natin ng break hours, kung let's say 1 hour break natin. Kung may grace period, lagay din natin yung grace period. This is for a minute grace period, hindi siya per hour. This is a minute. So let's say for example, we have 15 minutes grace period, so ipasok natin doon 15 minutes. Okay, so after that, just if ever man na ano, if ever na broken time yung ano, yung schedule ng employee, so you need to put the broken time hours. So let's say for example, on that first shift niya, nag 4 hours lang siya, and dito yung gap natin is 5. So babalik siya ng alas 6. Okay, so ganyan pa yung gumawa ng broken schedule, broken time schedule. Okay, so after that, if since this is only for demonstration, I put only a straight duty. So here 1 and 9 and 6 p.m. yung pasok niya. And the remarks naman, dito naman nakalagay din kanina, wherein makikita mo sa may payroll natin, payroll groupings natin, makikita mo dito meron tayong labor rates. So this is the dito nag-i-indicate kung deducted ba siya o hindi. So official business ba siya, leave without pay, leave with pay, official time off, and AWOL. So dito naka-indicate po yung multiplier niya. Okay, so back to the timekeeping. So since okay na, click natin proceed. Okay, so automatic pag click natin yan, it nag-change na kagad yung login logout ng employee. So after that, pag once okay na, nakapag-login na po, naka-schedule na po si ano, si meron tayong schedule si ano, si what's this, si employee, punta na tayo dun sa biometrics. So ito, naka-standby lang to dito sa labas ng gate natin or yung entrance natin for the employee, and dito sila mag-login. So lalagay mo yung fingerprint number niya. So let's say 001 yung number niya. So just put 1 and i-scan mo yung fingerprint niya or either saan dito yung ginagamit na fingerprints niya. Okay. So then mag-automatic, mag-re-record po dito. If ever may error man, nalabas po dito yung error ng schedule natin dito sa baba. Ayan. Ayan, dito lalabas yung schedule niya sa baba. So automatic, kung if ever fingerprint error man siya, so lalabas po yun. Makakita ni timekeeper kung anong nangyari, bakit hindi siya nakapag-login. If ever man, no, na hindi siya nakapag-login, it's because wrong schedule siya. Ang gagawin ni timekeeper is kailangan hintayin niya yung maintenance approval na pina-file po yun ng employee. Kung let's say hindi siya nakapag-login, it's because mali yung schedule na in-input. So, okay? So, kailangan, ang gagawin ni employee, no, pag once na hindi tugma yung in niya doon sa schedule, so kailangan inform si timekeeper para ma-adjust yung schedule niya. Okay? That's the time para magiging accurate po or ma-accept siya ng system natin. Dapat accurate yung in and out niya. Okay? In and out in the schedule, I mean. Okay? So, after that, so, since if naka-ever nakalagay na siya, okay, so, let's say, assuming tapos na yung 15 days, ang gagawin natin ngayon, pupunta na tayo si timekeeper, ang gagawin niya, mag-generate na siya ngayon ng work hours, overtime, differential, and the late of the employee. So, after that, no, click natin, so, let's say, magpa-process siya ng May 1 to 15. So, click this one. Okay? So, lalabas lahat kaagad yung in-encode natin na schedule per employee. Okay? So, this S1, oh, this is the in schedule for login and schedule for logout and schedule for second shift for login and the out. Okay, and dito natin makita naman sa L1. So L1, ito yung login natin. Ito na yung out. L3, in and out. And OT, let's say we have an OT over time. We have OT and OT out. Okay, so ito naman yung settings natin na ginawa natin for the scheduling. Okay, so we have here also the computed work hours natin. So, dito sa computed work hours natin, dito na makikita kung nag-fall ba siya sa rest day, nag-fall ba siya sa rest day, and special holiday, and regular holiday. So, this is dito nag-i-indicate, no? Doon sa multiplier natin, doon sa payroll groupings dito. Okay? So, we have here the work day, OT, and night differential. So, the same here on the timekeeping. No? Timekeeping natin kung saan siya nag-fall. Okay? And this is the overtime, night differentials, and also for the late natin, kung ilang minutes siya nag-late, ang holiday, and ito yung mga OB. So, iti-check mo lang yan. Let's say for that specific date, is naka-OB siya since kaya wala siyang log out, wala siyang log. So, iti-check mo lang po yun. Okay? So, then, this is the AOT. So, ibig sabihin naman nito, yung system kasi, yung system natin, nagko-compute siya automatic, no? Yung excess hours ni employee is kinocompute niya as overtime. So, depende na lang kung saan siya magpo-fall. Okay, na column. Okay, so if ever, no, na may overtime yan, hindi yan automatic masasama dun sa payroll natin. until the timekeeper will check this as authorized. Okay, so authorized po yun ng ano, authorized po yun ng timekeeper para maisama po dun sa may ano natin. So if ever man na, let's say for example, yung kinumpute ni system is 5 hours dito, pero yung allowed lang na overtime is 2 hours, ang gagawin ni system, ay ni timekeeper, gagawin niya din 2. Pero gagawin niya based dun sa final na overtime form ni employee. Hindi siya basta-basta mag-edit. So gusto hindi, 1 lang yan. So dapat meron kayang final si employee, no, na kung ilan yung overtime, authorized overtime, na signatured ng department head. Okay, so ganyan yung gagawin natin. So after that, okay, so wala naman tayong changes. So if ever after, okay na, no, nakapag-input na tayo ng overtime, compute na tayo, lahat-lahat. Ang gagawin natin ngayon, punta tayo ng compute log hours. Okay, pag-compute yan, si system na kaagad yung mag-compute lahat ng work hours natin. So dito yan lahat, ihilalabas ni system. Okay, based din sa login logout ng employee. So after that, pag once okay na tayo, then kukumpute natin yung mga changes. Okay, pag nakumpute na yung changes, so lahat automatic save na po yun. So once na okay na, pwede tayo makapag-print ng DTR ni employee. So dito tayo sa may DTR niya. Okay, so we have options of DTR formats dito. So depende na lang kung ano po yung format na mas comfortable kayo, no? Na ipag-print. So let's say for example, ayan. So this is the DTR format. So makita mo dito. So lalabas dito yung in and out ng employee kung meron man, and the computed hours natin. Okay, so dito lahat makikita mo. Okay, so after that, so since okay computed na lahat, na compute na ni timekeeping, ang gagawin ngayon ng taga payroll, punta na siya ngayon dito ng make payroll process na siya. Okay, so before that, gagawa muna dito si payroll officer, gagawa muna siya ng payroll period. So assuming gagawa tayo ng payroll period na ano, no, sample ito, ginawa natin payroll period. So in-add ko na yan for sample or for demo purposes lang. So ito yan, ginawa natin. So after that, since okay na tayo, punta tayo dito sa make payroll process. So select natin ngayon yung company na gusto natin i-process yung payroll, okay? Tapos select natin dito yung ito yung payroll period na i-process natin, click refresh. So automatic lalabas po yung employee na gusto natin i-process. Okay, so as you can see, makita mo yung dito yung field ng earnings. So lahat ng window dito, this is about earnings of employee. So makita mo dito yung monthly rate niya, allowance niya, daily rate niya, hourly rate niya. So dito nag-fall na ngayon yung kung ilan yung in and out ni employee. So we have here 15, no? Okay, so let's say, ayan. So let's say, may overtime siya. Pwede mo naman i-edit yun. Click mo edit, then let's say nagdagdag ka ng overtime na 6. Ayan, so pag-process mo ulit, kung compute yun sa system, ayan, mag-compute ulit yan. So mag-revision dito. So let's say dito, mali yung counts ng system. Sabihin natin, 14 days lang yan siya. So edit mo lang yan, update mo. And kung i-compute mo ulit yan, mababago yung work hours niya. Ayan. So mag-compute na siya. Ayan, mababago na yan. So let's say ito, kung nang 15 siya ulit, update. Ayan, so naging 23 na siya. Okay, so the same lang yan. Ito lahat, dito lahat yung mga logs niya. Total logs process natin. So ito may late siya. So makita mo, may late siya na piso per minute. So ito yung deduction niya, piso per minute. So work hours, ayan. So ito naman yung earnings code natin. Wherein you can add the month kung may mga additional earnings siya. So dito natin naman yung ginagawa sa may additional earnings. Ayan, kung may mga, let's say, for the earnings, ayan, dito tayo mag-add. Click natin add. No, ano ba yung earnings na yan? It's code for, let's say, additional allowance or incentives. You can put it here. So let's say another 15. So ano ba yung premium on divisor amount versus divisor? So this divisor natin is 1. So i-deduct niya every payroll. So ito one time lang. So ayan ang ginawa niya. So pwede naman by days. Okay, so dami, ano ka din. Tapos, lagay mo dito, let's say kung ito, one-time deduction lang. And start month niya. So, let's say this is for, let's say, kasi January yan. Ito, January. And the loan date natin, so let's say January 1 natin yan. And kailan natin i-deduct? Either first, okay? Pag same yung monthly kasi, lagay natin either sa second or sa fourth yung pipilian natin. So, i-deduct natin siya. Ipapasok natin yung earnings niya into second. Okay, so ito yung hold naman natin. So, do not pay with that specific payroll. So, i-hold mo siya. Now, example, hindi mo siya may pasok dyan kasi, let's say, nagka-something, di mo maibigay yung additional earnings na yan. So, i-hold mo siya that specific period. Okay? So, ganyan lang siya maglagay ng, no? So, add mo lang. Code as duplicate. So, meron na tayong na-add kasi na incentive. So, that's why hindi na tayo makapag-add another amount. Okay? So, meron na tayong nakaprocess. Okay? So, ganun din yun sa deductions natin. So, the same process with deductions, you can add also here. So, for the deductions. Okay? So, you can set what is that short ba siya? Charges ba siya? So, you can add it here. So, kung makita mo dun sa payroll natin, we have here 20 columns allocated for the other earnings natin. So, pero dalawa lang yung sinet natin. But we have options, no, until 20 earnings, column of earnings. Okay? Then the deductions naman, meron tayong deductions naman dito. 20 din yan. So, you can see here for the deductions, we have here for the SSS, PhilHealth, Pag-ibig, and withholding tax. So, nandito po lahat makikita natin. Utilities, so dito natin makakita yung import-export, no? Dito payroll. So, lahat yan dito natin ginagawa. Okay? Dito naman for the, ito naman yung total gross pay natin. Total gross pay natin ng earnings natin dito. Okay? And dito naman yung deductions, which is dito naman na tinatotal naman yung lahat ng deductions natin. Okay, and after that, this is the net pay. No? This is yung home pay ni, what's this, ni employee. Okay, so after that, if there is any changes of the of the payroll, you can click it here, no? Compute, and yes natin. So automatic system, kukompute po yun kung ano pa yung mga in-adjust natin. Since if ever final na, and if you want to check the negative and zero net pay, just click mo this one. Kasi hindi pwede yan na magiging zero or negative pay, negative yung ano ni, ano, ni employee. So check mo to. So lalabas po yung employee na may negative siya na net pay. So since wala namang lumabas, so ibig sabihin, clear po lahat na wala tayong negative net pay yung employee. So after that, since okay na, click natin to, close natin to, and punta na tayo ng reports. Dito sa reports, gagawa na tayo ng payroll registered natin. This is itong payroll registered. So, yung payroll registered naman, depende naman yun sa company formats natin. So, before that, we will customize the format of of the payroll registered based on the requirements ng company. Okay, so you can click it here. So, makikita mo kaagad yung total payroll register ng employee. So, meron tayong options naman dito na ganyan. And meron din tayong detailed or customized. Yan. Okay. Pwede din tayo maglagay tayo dito ng payslip. And ito, this is for the payslip. Okay. This one. Yan. Ito yung payslip natin. Sa payslip natin, makikita yung employee number natin. So, yung department, yung position natin, yung rate, and yung holiday natin, kung ilan ba yung work hours na or work day natin. And this is this box is for, intended for earnings, and this one for the deductions. Okay. So, after that, this one naman, ito naman yung sa baba, yung makita natin yung gross pay and deductions na net pay natin. So, we have here the received copy. So, if meron tayo ditong dots for cut dots natin, yung ikakat natin dito. No? So, ito yung magiging net pay. Ito yung maiiwan na received copy from the HR or yung sa payroll officer. Okay? So, yun yung payslip na format natin. But we can customize the payslip. Depende po yun sa company natin. Okay? So of course here we have a payroll bank transmittal, wherein we can print the payroll transmittal of employee of the those ano. So ayan, makita mo. So withholding tax, so pwede natin ma-print SSS. So kung meron mang SSS na na-generate sa atin, so ay nalabas po lahat yan. Okay? SSS, field health, contribution, etc. So nandito po lahat. Yung earnings, pwede natin makikita din siya. That's PCP. And for the 201 files, of course, makita natin yung mga 201 files ng employee. So you can check it here. Let's say you want to see the 201 files of employee. Nandito po lahat yan. So you can print it here. And pwede mo papirmahan sa kanya. Okay? So, dito naman for the mga labor natin, employments, pwede mo makita kung ilan yung active. So, lahat is admin. Meron tayong admin na apat. So, ito yung mga kinukuha ng mga ano sa labor department. No? Kung ilan yung counts ng female and total employee natin. So, nandito lahat yun. So you can print also the background of employee, educational background. So nandito lahat yung violations, leaves. So nandito lahat. Okay. So that's it. So that's the process of payroll. So aside doon, so isa sa mga features na hindi ko na discuss is yung ito yung mail monitoring, wherein fingerprint yung ginagamit natin, and itatype din yung employee number and ipapatch natin dito to monitor the mail monitoring natin per employee. So you can generate also the reports it here. Mail manning forecast natin. So, ilan yung magiging manning forecast natin? Lunch and dinner natin. Ayun. So, madaming natin dito. Ayan. So, yun. Since okay na tayo, so ito lahat yan. So, apat po na system natin yan. Included dun sa package natin. We in the payroll. The payroll, the timekeeping, the computerized biometric, and the mail monitoring biometrics natin. Okay, so that's it. So thank you. Hopefully na-discuss ko or na-pakita ko sa inyo a short demonstration of our payroll system and timekeeping. Thank you.